Okay, but that intro though. Okay, but that product feature though. You're welcome. So, what did you guys think? I actually put in a lot of effort into putting that very short sequence together. So, I knew for a fact that when I bought the palette, I had to feature it in its most glorious form, and that is to bring it to Disneyland, but not just any part of the park. Specifically, I wanted to bring it to Galaxy's Edge, or the city of Batuu for all you Star Wars fans out there. And I knew that it would just fit so perfectly well in it because not only is it a Star Wars collaboration palette, it also looks so opulent and it looks so fitting for the environment. Right after I received the package from the courier, I immediately drove my butt to Disneyland and then I filmed that whole sequence that everybody just saw. And one of the fear I had was not necessarily the public humility or the embarrassment of having to pull out a palette and film it like you're some psycho, but it was a fact. I honestly didn't want the palette to be damaged in any way because, in case you didn't notice, I placed it on a lot of different surfaces and I'm sure it's bound to be scratched, but you know, for YouTube, I guess. Wait, hold on, in English speakers, please, you know, stay in your seat. I just need to preface this video with another message for my Vietnamese viewers. Mọi người ơi, thì ngày hôm nay á, Bill quay cái review này á, thì chủ yếu là Bill muốn quay bằng tiếng Anh là tại vì khi mà Bill review những cái sản phẩm á, thì Bill cảm giác giống như là khi Bill nói tiếng Việt á, thì Bill nói không có chuẩn, nên Bill không có biết cách để dùng đúng từ, nên Bill cũng mong mọi người thông cảm. Với lại Bill biết là những người xài cái nhãn hiệu này là đa số là những người bên Mỹ, mà Bill cũng không có nên assume như vậy, tại vì Bill nghĩ là cũng có một số người ở Việt Nam cũng thích cái nhãn hiệu này. Nhưng khi Bill nói tiếng Anh thì tất nhiên nó rất là thoải mái đối với Bill, nên Bill mong mọi người thông cảm ha. Trong tương lai thì Bill sẽ cố gắng tập nói tiếng Việt thêm và để mong là một ngày nào đó Bill sẽ quay một cái video review rất là chuẩn cho mọi người hem. Rồi, xin lỗi mọi người nha. So, bright suns or rising moons, depending on when you're watching this video. My name is Billy and I am just a makeup consumer. I'm not a professional in any way. I'm just like you. I'm guessing you're an average consumer like I am, and you just want to be a little more informed about this product I'm about to review. So if you're interested, stick around and let's get into it. Today, I'm going to be doing a review on the Pat McGrath collaboration with Star Wars. And it's not just any product I'm reviewing, it's actually her Mothership palette. And it is not just any Mothership palette, actually. It is the very iconic, infamous, limited edition Decadence palette. Who's Pat McGrath exactly? That, I don't think I have to explain so much. And I'm sure you know why. If you're clicking on this video, I'm sure you have general knowledge on who she is. And for those of you who aren't aware of who she is a very iconic and very talented makeup artist. All her products are very geared towards people in the business, people who enjoy makeup and who do it professionally. But to a certain extent, it's also very welcoming for average consumers like you and me, who just do makeup for fun and love makeup for the sake of makeup. And so, I think when she specifically made this line of products, or her line, or her brand actually, she really had a very specific target demographic in her mind. And that is people who love makeup. It's that simple. Whether you're professional or amateur, if you love makeup, I'm sure you're gonna love what she has to offer. With that being said, this particular collaboration has a special place in my heart, and that's because it's with Star Wars. Personally, I am a huge fan of Star Wars. Not to the extent of a super fan necessarily, but I enjoy the world that George Lucas has created. Aesthetically speaking, it is beautiful. And it wasn't until recently that I realized that Star Wars is actually a space opera. Yep. Who knew? But anyway, today's review in particular is not necessarily going to be an in-depth one. I'm going to be speaking from my own personal experience, and for that reason, it could be potentially biased. And so I just want to preface that before I continue with what I'm about to say about this palette. What makes this collaboration so unique is in fact the packaging. In terms of the actual product itself, it's still the same. It's the same eyeshadow and it's the same formulation. But what makes this product so unique, in my opinion, is in fact what is holding the product itself, and that is the case or the makeup palette itself. I understand that there's a lot of frustration and concern when it comes to like her e-commerce. And so not a lot of people were able to get their hands on this palette. And for that reason, it became so highly coveted. But it also was extremely polarizing in my opinion, because some people would have like gone out of their way to try to get this. But some were just more like, well, if I do get it, I get it. If I don't, I don't, it's fine. But I understand that there's this sort of like setback on her end about it. And I do read the comments under her Instagram page, and I did notice that a lot of people voiced their frustration, and I totally get it. Personally speaking, I really do enjoy the high of having to stake out for products or for things that are limited edition. It's just, I find it entertaining. It's the rush of it all that just makes it feel so good when you finally get what you want. I don't know if everybody agrees with me. You don't have to, but you know, that's how I feel. Just like copping a pair of sneakers. That's how I feel about it too. But this one, I had to get my hands on it. I have it right in front of me right now, and I can't stop staring at it. And I'm sure you can already see it staring back at me through its reflection, but it is. How should I put this? If I could describe this palette in one word, it would be opulent. Right now, as I'm staring at it, it sort of looks like the briefcase in Pulp Fiction. It's gold, it's gleaming back at me, and you can't see it right now, but I do. Okay, just let me cut to the chase and show you the palette itself. And I oop, and I oop. We as consumers who enjoy Pat McGrath's Mothership palette has never seen anything like this before with this particular type of finish. It's mirrored, it's beautiful, it's gold. Personally speaking, I do not like gold one single bit, but this, however, this is a work of art. Hello, Pat McGrath.
You did amazing, sweetie.
All exaggeration aside, it's beautiful. You would have thought you paid $1,000 for this, but you only paid $125. And I get it. $125 for a palette, you ultimately pay for the formulation as well as a brand, let's be honest here. It's like buying a designer bag, but you also know that the quality is incredible. It would look beautiful on your vanity. And for those of you who do not like Star Wars, then tough luck, because there's a huge ass logo right on the palette. Let's talk a bit more about the packaging. I want to talk a little bit more about the outside. And so you might be wondering, what this? Right here, right? These four marks. Well, for some of you who are not Anglophiles, these are actually called UK hallmarks. And these are essentially stamps that are stamped onto silver products that are meant to be sold commercially in the UK. And so these stamps have a lot of different representation as well as different meanings. With that being said, it features a few. For example, this right here, it says PM. That means Pat McGrath. And what that means, if she were to stamp it onto actual silver products, is that it's the company's name. Following that is a letter L. I'm guessing that's her heritage. The brand itself, it's based in England. Well, in particularly London. But I could be wrong though, so don't quote me on that. And then following that is a crown. And so from my research, from my personal research, it looks like what the crown is meant to symbolize is the region of the country where the product was manufactured. And so different arms and different symbols have represents different regions of the UK. And then following that is an eye. And I think an eye in particular, it's not specific to UK products. It's just, it's part of Pat McGrath's aesthetic. So hopefully I gave you guys insight into a little bit more as to what the symbols mean, because it does have a meaning. I'm sure she really did thought about what she wants to put onto her products. And so I think that's incredible. I love it. The attention to detail, that's what really matters. And to think that consumers really glance over those kind of thing is sort of undermining, because we do notice a lot of things. And so that's something I wanted to point out. And so let me show everybody the inside. Okay, beautiful jewel tones. So, okay, I had some reservations about this palette initially, because I looked at the colors and I was like, low-key, okay, honestly, initial reaction, when I first saw the palette a few years ago, ew, the colors looked fugly. But, oh my gosh, wait until you guys swatch it. It's beautiful. Who knew it was so diverse in color? Because it seems like they're all from the same tone, like family tone, right? Like cooler tones, but no, it swatches very differently. For example, this color right here called Inferno, it looks kind of copperish in pan, but when you swatch it, it has a beautiful pink shade, almost duochrome, but not really. I can get more into this palette, but I'm not gonna swatch it on camera. I actually already did that beforehand, so I'm gonna insert a clip right here. And I did it under natural lighting. Look how beautiful it is. I mean, it's incredible. The finish is amazing. It glistens under light, but it's not offensive. It's very wearable to a certain degree, and it blends like a dream. With that being said, what's incredible about this palette is surprisingly its diversity. And the reason why I'm claiming that is because although it may appear to be more metallic, the gag of it all, actually, is that it can blend into a matte shade. Yes, best believe it can do that. So it can, in fact, go into your crease, because I believe in the process of blending out with a blending brush, it removes a lot of the metal finish, and so it leaves behind the color and powder. And so that in itself is already a matte color. There you go. You don't have to go out and get another palette to match, to find the right matte colors to correspond with each of these metallic shades, because they do, in fact, double as a matte. It's amazing. The technology behind this formulation in particular is what, in my opinion, sets Pat McGrath apart from all the other brands. Pat McGrath is known for this formulation, a very unique formulation, in fact, because it feels very creamy to the touch, almost as if it's wet, but not necessarily. It's that when you blend it, it just blends like a dream. And on top of that, it dries down like a powder. Best of both worlds, in my opinion. You don't have to stress about the fact that it's gonna be patchy. It's because the formulation itself, it doesn't give the product an opportunity to be patchy in the first place. It's because it already, like, once it goes into your lid, it already blends out on its own. It does a lot of work on itself, and I guess that's why it's $125. I do, in fact, currently own the Mothership palette in Bronze Seduction. It's a very diverse palette, in my opinion. It works amazing. I only bought it for $25. Yes, I did that. Smart consumers, where you at? Right here. I saved points from Sephora and just converted it to, gift cards, and then I just spent it on the palette. Sorry, I'm just, like, constantly cleaning it, because although it's beautiful, it's a mirror, essentially. So it does leave a lot of mark, and especially if you have greasy hands like I do, it does show. So I'm just, like, sitting here polishing it up. I actually did, in fact, play with it before I decided to sit down and talk to everybody about this. It's because I don't want to go blindly into it and, you know, make assumptions, because first of all, never assume. And second of all, and I'm sure everybody has heard this, there is, in fact, a learning curve with Pat McGrath Labs makeup. And the reason why is because of its formulation and the niche of people she's trying to target. And I'm guessing she's trying to target a lot of professionals, right? People who know how to manipulate products to make it work in their favor. And so try to experiment with it. Sometimes what it means is, you know, using a different base for your eye, using a different technique. Don't go too hard on certain colors. Go harder on certain colors. Wet your brush. Don't wet your brush. Wet your eye. Wet your finger. Apply it with a finger. Don't apply it with a finger. Apply it with a sponge. Do not apply it with a sponge. You have to go through that process to know what works for you. And on top of that, the chemistry of your skin, you know, oily lids, what do you need to do? You gotta prime it. Non-oily lids, maybe prime it with oil. And so all that really does factor in when it comes to applying products, because the way I wear this palette today won't necessarily match with how you wear the product. It's because we all wear it differently and we use different techniques and we know what works best for us and what doesn't. And so I guess that is applicable to all other products, but hers in particular, there is in fact a learning curve. So initially, don't be turned off. Don't return the palette yet. Give it some time. Try to at least put together three looks. If you can't put together three looks, then yeah, maybe it's not for you. Maybe it's too challenging, or maybe it just doesn't work with your skin, or you just don't like the formulation. That's totally fine. But, you know, give it a fair chance before you put together your final decision, right? Because it is, in fact, an investment piece. Ain't nobody got $125 laying around for a palette. Unless if you do, then, you know, kudos to you. Yeah, it's great. I know I'm gonna get some good use out of it, and I'm happy that I did make this purchase. I don't know. All I have to say is, it's amazing. And if you do have an opportunity to get your hands on it next time, then please do. And if you guys would like to see me do a makeup tutorial on it, maybe perhaps do something a little more unconventional or something that is more wearable, then please let me know in the comment section down below. Other than that, I think that's about it. Thank you so much for clicking on this video to begin with. This is in fact my first makeup product review, so there is in fact a learning curve, and please give me constructive criticism so I know what else I need to work on. But I think that's about it. If you guys are watching this video, you know, first thing in the morning, then I hope you guys have a wonderful day. But if you're about to head to bed, then I hope you guys have a good night's sleep. Thank you very much, and I'll see everybody soon. Bye.